Hi everyone. Today let's talk about a beautiful ornamental plant, bleeding heart or clerodendron. Tune with me until the end of the video to know about its care and propagation. Bleeding heart vine is grown as an ornamental plant for its decorative two-colored flowers. It is a well-behaved, non-aggressive plant that can reach around 3 feet in containers but can climb to 15 feet at maturity. I have two varieties, one is white and red and the other one is purple and red. The flowers of bleeding heart are arresting with crimson petals emerging from white base. The vines are a rich source of nectar and they attract butterflies outdoors. The flowers are borne in terminal clusters of 8 to 20 together. The flowers last for several months. As they age, the flowers turn from white to pink. They eventually become tan as they dry up. It will bloom most of the year given sufficient light and warmth, but is most prolific in summer. It is vigorous grower when provided with sufficient water and fertilizer. Bleeding heart do best in partial shade. Partial shade means less than 5 hours of direct sun each day. In most locations, plants prefer morning sun and afternoon shade. From spring until winter, water regularly to keep the soil moist but not waterlogged. Bleeding hearts won't tolerate wet soil over winter or dry soil in summer. Bleeding heart prefers humus-rich moist soil with lots of organic matter. It prefers slightly acidic soil but will do fine in neutral soils. Spread 2 to 3 inch layer of organic matter such as compost or well-rotted manure over the existing soil. Work it into improve aeration and create a loose soil that allows the roots to grow. It prefers a well-draining soil that will not let the roots get soggy and rot. Bleeding heart vine is easy to propagate by cuttings. Semi-ripe tip cuttings can be rooted in water or moist sand or other medium. It can take 10 days to 3 weeks before rooting occurs. Seeds can also be planted in spring. Bleeding heart live well as container plant, but conditions need to be right. When potting it, opt for a large container, at least a 12-inch pot. They can become a substantial plant growing more than 3 feet tall. If the bleeding heart develops small brown or black spots on the leaves, then the plant likely has fungal leaf spot. Treatment with a fungicide or baking soda solution may neutralize the fungus if caught early enough. As the disease progresses, the leaves drop and the plant will die. To trigger the plant to bloom again and again, you can stimulate new growth by cutting the plant down to 1 inch of the ground surface. So that's it for today guys. Do try these simple tips to grow this beautiful plant. If you like this video, do subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.